Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. This video series is focusing on indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. In our previous video, we learned how to represent the Slutsky's substitution effect diagrammatically when price of one commodity falls. In this video, we shall take a look at the diagrammatic representation of another scenario, which is a rise in the price of commodity X. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. So by now, since you've seen two videos on Slutsky's substitution effect, we are aware that Slutsky focuses on cost difference to keep the real income of the consumer constant. All right. Just like the previous video, this video also will have a diagrammatic representation and a numerical example for you all to understand and get a better grasp at the topic. So let the money income of the consumer be $25. This is the same as the previous video. And just like the previous video, price of commodity X is $2 and price of commodity Y is $3. The initial quantity purchased is 5 units of good X and good Y respectively. So spending on good Y is $3 times 5 units is $15, and spending on good X is $2 times 5 units, that is $10, right? So as a total, consumer is spending the whole of his money income, which is $25. So as mentioned earlier, we are focusing on a rise in price of commodity X. So let the price of commodity X be, say, $3. Now to purchase same quantity, consumer will need $3 times 5, that is $15, right? There is no change in good Y. So the expense will still remain at $15. That is, consumer now needs $30 to buy the same combination, right? But how much is his total income? His total money income is $25. That means, this indicates that income of consumer has to be raised. So why do we need to raise the income of the consumer? Because the real income of consumer, has gone down due to a rise in the price of commodity X. And by how much do we need to raise the income? Since we are talking in terms of Slutsky's substitution effect, we know that he talks about cost difference. So what is the cost difference between $30 and $25? It is $5. So the income of the money income, let me write that down. So the money income of consumer has to be raised by $5. All right. The Slutsky's formula, delta Px Qx, that is change in price of X, which is $1, times the quantity that he was buying, which is 5. That comes to $5 again. If we calculate based on this formula, we'll again be able to get the cost difference by which the money income has to be raised in this case. All right, let's take a look at the diagram. So this is the y-axis with good Y, x-axis with good X. This is the initial budget line, AB, the initial IC curve, point of equilibrium E, and the quantity consumed, of commodity X is Q. All right. Now, what did we assume? We assumed that the price of commodity X is increasing. Now, when the price of commodity X increases, what will happen to the budget line? The budget line will rotate inwards. On which axis? On X axis. Let us say this is the budget line AB1. Now, since price of X has gone up, will consumer buy, logically, will the consumer buy same quantity? No. He will have to reduce the quantity of commodity X because it is relatively expensive, right? However, Slutsky says the consumer will buy initial combination. And what are we doing? We are increasing his money income, right? When income increases, what happens? The budget line, it will shift parallel outwards. Where will it shift? It will shift outwards parallel to this budget line, which is AB1. All right, let's shift it outwards. So let us say this is the new budget line, the one in green. Let me name it as LM. All right, so this budget line LM is passing through point E, which was the initial combination, right? If you've seen the videos on consumer equilibrium through indifference curve, you would know that a consumer would be in equilibrium when the indifference curve is tangent to the budget line, which was at the initial situation with budget line AB and indifference curve IC at point E. Now, at point E with the budget line LM, it is crossing this equilibrium point. Consumer is not maximizing his utility. Now, if the consumer is rational, what will he do when the price of a commodity rises? He will buy less of it and buy more of the other cheaper commodity. Now, since consumer is not at equilibrium at point E because his satisfaction is not getting maximized, he will behave rationally and follow this segment. So when consumer does this, he will be on an equilibrium at a higher indifference curve. Let us say at IC1 at E1. Now at E1, this is the quantity consumed by the consumer of commodity X, and this is the quantity that he is buying of commodity Y. So, to maximize utility, consumer will substitute a relatively expensive commodity for a cheaper one at IC1, which is this, and point E1, which is this, where consumer is buying less of X1. So the quantity of commodity X consumed has gone down from Q to Q1. All right, children, this is how the Slutsky's substitution effect would be represented when the price of a commodity rises. I hope you've understood the Slutsky's substitution effect. Students, if you find my videos useful, please do like and subscribe to my channel. Share my videos with your friends as well. If you find learning through long videos difficult, you can follow me over my Instagram channel, where you would learn a lot of these concepts through reels, which is a much shorter duration than this. And follow me on my Facebook page as well. The links are available in the description box to get notified for the notes and quizzes that I'll be releasing there. All right. So I'll meet you in another video with another topic. Bye now. Take care.